On April 5th, 1993, the software and semiconductor giant Nvidia was founded by Chris Malachowski, Curtis Priam, and Jensen Huang. In the early 90s, video games were a booming industry, largely attributed to the success of the Nintendo Entertainment System. Suddenly, the video game industry was now worth over $1 billion, so the three young Nvidia boys observed this reality closely and saw a massive opportunity. They realized that video games, as well as the broader computer market, was being completely held back due to poor hardware that they knew how to make. While the Nvidia founders had nothing but ideas at this point, they were incredibly knowledgeable, especially in this area. Jensen Huang had a master's in electrical engineering from Stanford, and he had also worked at one of Nvidia's biggest rivals, AMD. The other co-founders, Chris and Curtis, had similarly impressive backgrounds, and together the three of them knew that they had what it took to disrupt and take over the graphics market. With only $40,000 in the bank, they sought investment from venture capitalist firms. The boys showed these investors just how valuable they were to this billion-dollar industry. This scored them $20 million in funding from Sequoia Capital and other VC firms. After just 2 short years of building up its infrastructure, staff, and research, in 1995, Nvidia launched their very first product, which they called the NV1. The NV1 was marketed as the world's first mainstream multimedia processor, and its launch was partnered with one of Nintendo's rivals, Sega. The NV1 kind of flopped due to high competition in the marketplace and no real ability to stand out from the crowd. This was a frustrating loss. Nvidia was now burning through cash, and this abysmal performance certainly did not attract new investors. But after a few more years of research in the Nvidia labs, they struck gold. Well, more like silicon, but whatever. In 1997, Nvidia launched the Riva 128, the world's first 128-bit 3D processor. Riva stood for Real-Time Interactive Video and Animation Accelerator, and this thing was fantastic. The Riva managed to cement Nvidia's presence within the graphics market, and they sold over 1 million units of this thing in the first 4 months of its launch. And shortly after, Nvidia capitalized on this success with the Riva TNT in 98 and the TNT 2 Ultra in 99. Now, while these microchips were great options depending on the circumstance, they were far from the only choice. There was this company that you've probably never heard of called 3DFX Interactive, and they were Nvidia's main rival throughout the 90s. Everything Nvidia did, as well as other competitors, were compared to 3DFX's line of Voodoo chips, which were the industry standard. The NV1 had previously lost to Voodoo, but the Riva line was finally a match for them. Although Nvidia didn't want to be in the market, they wanted to be the market. Nobody, not even 3DFX, the industry leader, knew what was about to happen next. If you listen to me closely, you'll know I haven't said a particular term, which is basically synonymous with Nvidia. That's right, in 1999, Nvidia released the GeForce 256, the world's first graphical processing unit, the GPU. Nvidia coined this device as the world's first single-chip processor with integrated transform, lighting, and rendering engines, and it was capable of producing a minimum of 10 million polygons per second. This chip absolutely destroyed its competition. The GeForce 256 immediately became the go-to graphics card. It was being put in millions of devices worldwide. And Nvidia was constantly innovating. They made the GeForce line better and better with every product iteration. 3DFX was hopeless, and they knew there was nothing they could do about it. To make matters even worse, on November 15, 2001, Nvidia partnered with Microsoft to launch their very first console, the original Xbox. With the demand of Nvidia's products skyrocketing, they made over $1 billion in 2001, and they nearly doubled it to $2 billion in 2002. It didn't really look like Nvidia could do any better. But in the early 2000s, something else was just becoming popular. Something we use now every day, pretty much every second. Yeah, the internet, that thing. Google, Microsoft, and Amazon were spending billions of dollars to make server farms that could store and retrieve information from their services. While at first these systems didn't need too much graphical processing, meaning there wasn't that much need of a GPU, the 2010s flipped this on its head. Around 2013, something was becoming unfathomably valuable, and I'm sure you've heard of it due to ChatGPT. Artificial intelligence. All of a sudden, every company, whether it was software-based or not, was predicted to die unless it leveraged AI. Businesses were scrambling to figure out how to do this fast. Some would use AWS, and others would buy their own hardware. But no matter what anyone did, it always pointed back to just one company. Artificial intelligence relies on something called machine learning, which is very math and computationally heavy. these AI calculations generally boil down to simple linear algebra. You know what else is linear algebra? Video games, and more generally, computer graphics. Nvidia smiled with glee as the demand for their cards skyrocketed beyond imagination. Nearly every company needed to train AI models extensively using their GPUs. Whether companies bought their own machines or leveraged them seamlessly over the cloud, Nvidia rode the wave and eventually multiplied their 2002 revenue 14 times to over $28 billion. At the time of writing, on February 1st, 2023, Nvidia is the 10th most valuable company in the entire world. Nvidia has state-of-the-art GPUs in desktops, laptops, server farms, and even cars. While Nvidia today is generally considered unmatched, they do have competitors in their space, with AMD actually having the chip in both the current Xbox and PlayStation. On the other hand, one of Nintendo's best-selling consoles and current flagship, the Switch, has one of Nvidia's cheaper chips to help keep costs down. Also, Nvidia is heavily involved in artificial intelligence research, and the software they create continues to change the way that humans operate. Personally, I'm really excited to see what they have next, and please watch this next section. You will want to. To celebrate GTC 2023, Nvidia's upcoming conference, I am doing a massive giveaway, which I'll talk about just after this. So Nvidia's GTC 2023 is going to be a fascinating event, where they're going to talk about so many cool things, largely focused around AI these days. Look at all the amazing people that are involved here. I, for one, always watch the keynote. Okay, here's the form for the giveaway. You're going to have to enter this. So the prizes, one third place winner will receive a $20 Canadian gift card. Five second place winners will receive an Nvidia Deep Learning Institute self-paced course credit, and the first place winner, I'm sorry, but you must have a North American shipping address for prize one, will receive a GeForce RTX 3080 Ti GPU. Like, look at this thing. This thing is absolutely insane. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks so much for watching. I know you're going to enjoy the conference coming up, so make sure you watch those sessions, and I'll see you guys later. Thanks so much.